guys, welcome back. Ladies and gents, I have a small haul for you guys today. I've been busy, been backed up, I'm calm but constipated again. Busy doing stuff, doing dad stuff, like had to take apart my kids' PS4 because it was overheating. If you guys have never taken apart a PS4, don't do it. It sucks. So if you guys have never done anything technical like that, it really sucks to take one apart. I did that. I had to cut a hole in my ceiling because I had a leak underneath my shower upstairs. But, you know, typical dad stuff. Take kids to school. Get them ready for school. School shopping. Had to do a lot of that. So, all that's done. So, anyway, get back to stories. I'd like to welcome you guys back. And so, I had to drop my dog off to the vet one day. And so, it was a drop-off appointment. I had 3 hours to kill. So, I decided to go to the pawn shop that I went to before. If you look a bunch of videos back, I had a pawn shop haul. I remember there were still a few books that I didn't look at over there. They were all 50 cents each. I didn't have time last night because I had my baby girl with me and she was very impatient. Didn't want to sit there and wait for daddy to look through a bunch of comic books. So this time I had some time to kill. Went over there and just decided to look at what I left behind. So first off, I picked up 4 issues of Death's Head 2 number 1. I'll pick these up 50 cents all day, some for a buck or more. Definitely pick those up. I got the second print, which is a silver cover. They didn't have the gold. I wish I had the golden, but nope, didn't have the gold over there. I got a pretty cool Spirits of Vengeance Venom cover. Guys, check that out. Really like that cover. Got a Darkhawk Venom cover. Always pick those up. There's a bunch of Darkhawk completionists out there. They will buy these, so I'll pick them 50 cents all day. I got a Lobo Paramilitary Crystal Special. These I can sell for a couple bucks all day. Definitely pick these up 50 cents. Marvel Comics Presents 74, part of the Weapon X storyline. I'll definitely pick these up 50 cents all day. I got the Sandman Orpheus. See that there? Sandman Orpheus number 1. This is a glow-in-the-dark cover. Check that out. So all this white right here that you guys see on the eyes and everything else, this is all glow-in-the-dark. Hold on. You guys see it's glowing a little bit? So there you go. You guys kind of see what it is. Alright, so anyway, so that's a glow-in-the-dark cover. Show and tell. I got another Darkhawk number 14. Another Venom cover. Pretty cool Venom cover. Venom's hot right now, so books like that are easy to sell. I got the War of Gods number 2. The only reason why I got these was I just thought it was cool because they had the direct edition and they had the newsstand edition over there. So I grabbed them both. You see, they're pretty similar. There's just subtle changes on them, like the color and everything else. I got Detective Comics number 609, which is the, I think, second appearance of Anarchy. And then I got another Lobo Paramilitary Special. So that's 2. Next up, I got Full Killer number 10. I have 1 through 9, I think, on eBay. And I didn't have 10, so there's 10. I'm going to add to it, so I'm going to change my eBay listing. So that's the whole first, I guess, full mini of Full Killers, number 1 through 10. I picked up 2 copies of Ragman, number 1. Ragman's supposed to be making his debut again, so I picked these up. 50 cents each, great condition. I'll sell them for a buck, I don't care. I got a Venom Finale, number 3. Of course, like I said, Venom's hot right now. I'll pick him up. Venom Lethal Protector 5. Venom Lethal Protector 6. There's no order, guys. Just throwing them together. Number 6. Pneumo Trace. And I always pick up Liefeld stuff. I mean, I know people don't like Liefeld, but I pick them up anyway. So this is Captain America number 2 and number 4. Liefeld covers. Venom Sign of the Boss number 1. Pick that up. Star Wars Dark Empire number 3. Great cover. I love this cover. It's actually on my wall over here. Venom Lethal Protector number 2. Deathstroke the Terminator number 10. This is the first appearance of the new Vigilante. See that? Vigilante over here. got a second copy. First Barney Gumble, Simpsons. A lot of these books need to be pressed, which I mean is expected. They're 50 cents each, but I'll definitely press them before I put them on eBay, so that way they'll look a whole lot better than they were. And these I always pick up. Superman Man of Steel number 17. This is the first print. Whatever Doomsday storyline I find, especially the first ones, I'll always pick them up, especially 50 cents. I mean, man, can't beat that. And I heard from somewhere, I can't remember, but they said that they're going to make Doomsday relevant again, and he's going to have a big storyline coming up pretty soon. So I always pick up Doomsday stuff. Here's another Superman number 74, right before he kills Superman. Or, yeah, destroys him, basically. 74. That one is also first print. Picked up X-Men number 1. I always pick these up. Jim Lee art. Then I got the Captain America Bloodstone. I got 358. This one, Crossbones first comes out. 359. 360. And 362. Of course, 361 was there, but I have a ton of copies of that anyway, so it doesn't matter to me. But I will definitely sell these. They're all newsstand. I'll sell them all together. Azrael's coming back out again, so I picked up the Azrael number 1. Fantastic Four 11, the first appearance of her. Guardians of the Galaxy, she might make an appearance. So I'll definitely pick this up 50 cents. This is Batman's Shadow of the Bat, first appearance of the new Batwoman. Batwoman or Batgirl? I don't remember. I think Batwoman. Deathstroke the Terminator number 15, first appearance of Rose Wilson. And Batman, Death in the Family, this is Batman number 427. Definitely pick those up 50 cents all day. This one has a huge spine roll. Look at that. Jeez. Huge, huge spine roll. You can see where the staple's at right here. This one is one of the first ones I'm going to press before I put on eBay. But if you guys go to eBay, you'll see before and after of what this looks like. But huge spine roll that I got to get out of this thing. So I got to press that. Last but not least, I got a trade paperback. It's a Program for Damage. This is the Scud Disposable Assassin. Got that for 50 cents. I will buy cheap trade paperbacks because I put these on eBay for $5 and man, you won't believe how many people will snatch these things up, especially for $5. I've been selling a lot of trade paperbacks lately. Like I get them in hauls where people just throw them in for free and I'll put them on eBay for $5 and sell them all day. So, well guys, that's pretty much it. Daryl appreciates you guys coming here and checking out his videos. Again, like, comment, subscribe, share it if you know somebody that likes these videos. Definitely hook them up. I have a haul that I'll be doing soon, maybe within next week. I want to do a quickie contest again. That'll hopefully be pretty soon. I'll be submitting about 60 some books to CGC soon. Oh, speaking of that, I got accepted as a witness for CVCS. So if there's a small con or a con coming up, I haven't been going to cons that much lately this year, but at the closer to October time frame, I will be going to AZ VentureCon. It's free. There's going to be a lot of artists there. I wasn't able to go last year, but this year I'm going to take a month off from work and hopefully definitely go to that. And I got some big things planned for my channel. You guys stay tuned. I'm going to have some really cool stuff coming up soon. So I appreciate you guys watching. Again, love you guys. Peace. Hey guys, I just want to come back with a quick show for you guys. So that Batman 427 that I showed you earlier, I did a quick press on it. And I just want to show you what a quick press can do to a spine roll. Remember how bad that spine roll was? If you take a look at the back now, look at that, spine roll is pretty much almost gone. So that was just from a quick press. Like, I didn't even do anything special with it. I just did a quick press on it. But that's how it looks now. There's the front. Remember how badly the spine was rolled all the way out here, probably about a quarter of an inch out. But this is how it looks now. Huge dramatic difference compared to what it used to be. I'll post before and after pictures so you guys can see a side-by-side of it. But just want to show you what a quick press can do. Definitely looks way better. It's turning from a 50-cent book that I paid 50 cents up to $5 or more. So, all right, guys. Just want to show you guys. Later.
Opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment. Did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud. He opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking, how? Everybody's choking.